Blackstone Audio presents Suspended Sentences, Three Novellas, by Patrick Modiano, translated from the French by Mark Polizzotti. This book is read by Bronson, Pinchot, Sean Runnette, and Arthur Morey. Introduction. Missing, by Mark Polizzotti. A feeling of indirection pervades many of Patrick Modiano's writings, and the three short novels in this volume are no exception. For all the specificity of detail, locations catalogued with loving precision, particular casts of light and shadow, one can't escape a sense of haziness, as if everything were shrouded in gauze or viewed through a Vaselined lens. The narrative voice adds to this impression, the protagonists often placing themselves just to the side of the situation they're describing. Like the prose in which they couch their stories, these narrators maintain a slight remove, as if full engagement with one's surroundings carried the threat of great pain or mortal danger. Readers familiar with Louis Malle's film Le Comble Lucien, 1974, for which Modiano co-wrote the screenplay, will recognize this disengagement. It's the same unconsciousness that lets the title character drift into the world of French fascism, as if by accident. In the novellas included here, a similar diffidence colors the author's efforts in Afterimage to sort out his memories of the photographer Janssen, and the attempts by Patoche, the 10-year-old hero of Suspended Sentences, to penetrate the dubious adult world in which he and his brother live. Even the somewhat more skeptical protagonist of Flowers of Ruin is stymied by his inconclusive pursuit of the elusive Pacheco. What becomes clear as we read these books is that the inconclusiveness of the pursuit is central to the story, indeed is the story. Modiano's narrators seem fatally drawn to individuals who are uncommonly vague about themselves and their situation, people whose ability to engage the writer's emotional investment and one's senses to cause him harm stands in inverse proportion to the amount of reliable information he's able to garner about them. Each of these novellas turns around a gap, a center that cannot hold, the nebulous Pacheco, the taciturn Janssen, for whom, in turn, the departed Robert Capa and Colette Laurent open a breach, and, for little Patoche, the figure of Annie, she of the bobbed hair, leather jacket, and exotic blue jeans, at once big sister and pre-adolescent crush, the main actor in a play of bewildering dialogues, entrances, and exits. It's as if each of these figures held the key to a great conundrum, as if they alone could bring everything into focus, but never do. Then again, perhaps this is intentional, for as Modiano confesses elsewhere, the more obscure and mysterious things remained, the more interested I became in them. I even looked for mystery where there was none. As befits the wistful undertone of these narratives, their setting is mainly a world gone by. Time and again, we're reminded that a particular Parisian building or neighborhood was later razed to make room for something else, or are given a privileged introduction to an obscure nook of the city, usually near the outskirts, that harks back to earlier decades. The Hameau du Danube, the Potin des Peupliers. One could easily read these novellas as a three-part love song to a Paris that no longer exists, or that most people's eyes do not see. Despite the action's contemporary setting and the frequent references to bright sunlight, we find ourselves plunged into the atmosphere of Marcel Carné's fog-drenched films, Edith Piaf's smoky laments, and Brassai's nocturnal photographs. And, fittingly as well, the geography is more often than not the working-class neighborhoods of the city's northern quarters, or Saint-Germain-des-Prés, before it became overrun with tourists and new money. The periphery, the zone, the no man's land where people stay just outside the law to get by, this is the territory of these novellas. Few French writers have evoked Paris with as much fondness and nostalgia as Modiano. Baudelaire comes to mind, glowering with disapproval at the newly Osmanized boulevards as he memorializes the swarming city, city filled with dreams. For while the cityscape is quick to change, less so the human heart. So does Aragon, the Paris peasant, conserving the gallerias of the second arrondissement and their alluring defunct storefronts. Modiano's fictions offer a connoisseur's excavation of the capital.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.